I'm nearly on the floor again.
It must be the size of your backside. We used to all fit on this seat.
Shh!
We've got to listen up to the overture. It's late tonight. The director gets us ready earlier every night. I'm sure he is panicking.
Keith doesn't panic. Great bloke.
Creep.
Joey's the panicky one. 45 minutes he spent in the toilet earlier.
The queue became so long, Chandler had to nip out the back.
Tittle-tattler. I whipped across the road to the pizza place and used theirs. And I ordered everyone pizza for the interval.
I hope you washed your hands.
Yeah. Thebes, what are you doing?
I'm waving to all my friends.
Friends?
Thank you.
Yeah. congratulations.
What music have we got on the show this year?
I'm not sure, but there'll be something for everyone.
I doubt it. They won't have any Joe Loss.
No, but it's a gang show, so there'll be plenty of Rolf Reeder in the show. And you like his material. It's timeless.
You didn't always like the music I used to play.
Music? Music? You call that racket music?
Who did you used to listen to, Dad?
Well, there were groups like The Animals, The Rolling Stones, and of course, The Monkees.
Here we come, walking down the street. Get funny looks from everyone we meet. Hey, hey, the monkeys, we turn monkey around. We're too busy singing, twirl anybody down. We go wherever we want to, do what we like to do.
I need you.
I was a mod.
Yeah.
Davison, Jim Davison,
Harry Seacombe, Michael Bentine.
Was Elvis Presley ever in the game show?
I don't think so, even if he was the king.
So I suppose you'll be trying to tell me that you invented fashion next.
Fashion? Fashion? You kids don't know what fashion is.
You're a fine one to talk about fashion.
I heard that. I was even more gorgeous than usual when I had my stepping out gear on.
That's right. I remember. My little boy.
Mother, please.
Did you wear trendy clothes, Mum?
Oh, yes. All the time.
And since when has green crinkly been trendy?
That wasn't my fault. My parents used to make me wear that when I went to posh dances with them. I even had to have ballroom dancing lessons.
Didn't do much good then. You still managed to tread on my feet all the time.
What was that?
He said it was a good job he didn't have any blue suede shoes for you were ever standing on his feet.
Don't look at me with a hound dog expression.
Thank you.
looking forward to the gang show, even if they won't be performing anything we've been talking about.
Thank you. getting on with his new sledge. He was pleased with it, wasn't he, Sue?
And so he should be. You do spoil him, Arnold. You paid a lot of money for that sledge. But I'll never forget his little face when he first saw it.
I'll bet that surprised that family next door. Their son never had a sledge as good as our Michael's.
Who cares about the folk next door? They don't even have a piano.
Well, neither do we.
That's different. We don't want one.
Do they? Have they said so?
No, but they've hinted. Only the other morning, I heard her ask her daughter if she'd done her scales.
Look at the size of her, she ought to be doing her scales. And they'd have to be fairly hefty ones at that. I can't wait for our Michael to get home. Tell me how fast his new sledge went. I can see all his friends wanting to have a go on it.
Well, I hope he doesn't let them. It's brand new and it costs a lot of money. I think he should keep it just to himself.
No, you can trust our Michael. Takes after his father. He's got his head screwed on the right way. He knows his business. That sledge is his, and he's so jealous of it, nobody's going to get within a mile of it.
I'm longing to hear about it too when he comes. I expect he'll be cold, so I've got some hot scones for him. You know, the ones he likes so much. Those with a cup of tea will soon warm him up. Oh, listen, I think that's him. Yes, he's back. Do you think he'll bring the sledge right in here?
It might have snow on it. He might leave it in the hall.
Oh, Dad, it was wonderful. It was fantastic. You've never seen a sledge go so fast.
That's all I wanted to hear, son. That's all I wanted to hear. I bet it made all your mates jealous, didn't it?
You're kidding. They all said it was the most terrific thing they'd ever seen. It was too. Must have gone 60 to 70 miles per hour. It was like I was flying.
Did you leave it in the hall, dear?
In the hall. No,
it
wasn't there. I loaned it to somebody.
You loaned it to someone? You loaned that new sledge to somebody? Who? Who did you loan it to?
I don't know. It was a stranger.
A stranger?
Michael, you loaned your new sledge to a stranger? Somebody you didn't know? You gave it to some unknown loafer who's taken your sledge and gone off with it? Oh, he did, and he said, oh, yes, Michael, I'll bring it back. What did he do then? Laugh his flipping head off. Do you realise what you've done? Do you ever expect to see that sledge again?
Yes, Dad, he promised.
Oh, so he promised. He said, yes, I'll bring it back. I thought you were going to be a businessman, to grow up, to know the right way, to be shrewd like your father, to know the right thing to do, not do the cockeyed, daft, idiotic piece of lunacy of giving a brand new sledge that cost me £50 to someone you didn't know. It must have gone off your head. You've lost your senses. That's if you ever had any.
Keep quiet a moment, dear. There's someone at the door.
I'm not finished with you yet, my boy. I've still got plenty to tell you.
Arnold, this is Mr. Framley and his son, Roger.
How do you do?
How do you do?
We've come to return the sledge which your son so kindly lent my boy Roger. He's had a most wonderful time on it, and we are really extremely grateful.
Oh, yes, it's very kind of you, Mr. Framley. I'm glad you enjoyed using it, Roger.
Never had such a fast ride before. There's a streak of lightning.
Thanks for letting me have a bash, Michael. Would you care for a cup of tea, Mr. Framley?
No, thank you. Must be getting home. Wife is expecting us. We just wanted to return the sledge.
Well, of course, that's fine. We wondered what time he would return it. He said that you would be bringing it back. My son loans things out all the time, but he hasn't much of a business head.
Hasn't he? Here's his sledge, Michael. Can I have my dad's gold watch back now, please?
joke. You've probably heard it before. But I have a talent, a wonderful thing. Cause everyone listens when I start to sing. I'm so grateful and proud. All I want is to sing it.
Thank you. Thank you. No, no. wash.
I washed this morning.
I saw you. You washed in the porridge.
The only thing you can do with it, you can eat it.
Why not? I cooked it. And it was all right. You can't tell me that porridge was burnt.
Burnt? It was raw. I don't believe you even put water with it. It was like eating sawdust. We blew it away.
I wish I had a can of Coke.
Hey, there's a big house over there. Maybe they've got some water.
Maybe they got some Coke.
You'll have water and like it.
Okay, I have water and like it.
How do you know you'll like it?
Because he said so.
What about going over there to that house and asking them for some water?
Let's wait till we find a small house. That one looks too posh. I wouldn't feel at home.
You don't plan to stay there for a couple of weeks, do you?
I don't like posh places. I ain't used to that sort of thing. Down to earth, Cedric, that's me.
You ain't even used to civilization yet.
Oh, yes I am. What do you think I am? A monkey.
Cedric, we're all monkeys once, but some of us jump further than others.
What happened to you? Couldn't you jump?
Say, good heavens, I never scout job we.
Do you know? Bad more doors slammed in my face now.
Come on, we're going over there and asking for some water.
Well, you can do the asking. Wouldn't know what to say to those toffs who live there. Besides, I haven't manicured my nails.
Come on, and at least try and look human.
Lick your face, mud, it's filthy. My tongue's not long enough.
Is your hanky there?
I ain't got a hanky. Here, use mine.
Has anyone got a comb?
No, you broke mine this morning. Trying to get it through that matted barbed wire of yours.
You are only jealous of my lovely hair.
Come on, they'll welcome us with open arms.
Huh, now it's a prophet.
And we're very thirsty. We only want some water.
I think we're going to get some coffee. You like coffee?
Yes, thanks, if it's got sugar.
It'll have sugar. Here's Mrs. Monkey now.
Hello. I hear you're thirsty. Like coffee?
Yes, please, madam. We don't want to bother you.
No bother at all. It's all ready, and I'll bring it in. No need for you to wait. Can handle this lot.
Right, madam. See you tomorrow.
Just make yourselves at home, and I'll get the coffee. Won't be a minute.
That was darn nice of her.
This is too posh for me.
I don't like it.
Oh, shut up. It's superb.
I ain't used to drinking the upper class. I don't know what to do.
What to do? What do you mean you don't know what to do?
Yeah, well, don't you all drink with crooked fingers?
Listen, dopehead, all you have to do is watch her and do exactly as she does. Then you can't go wrong.
Maybe we'll learn a few new manners.
It's about time
we learn
some of the old ones.
Now, listen, here she comes. Just do exactly as she does and you can't go wrong.
Hope it'll be sweet enough for you. Think I've put plenty of sugar in.
Guess you like it sweet.
Maybe a little sweetening.
Was that crack?
Just watch her.
I ain't taking my eyes off her.
Now, is everybody comfortable?
We're fine, thanks.
Good. Here we go.
Thank you.
She's like the wind through my tree. She rides the night next to me. She leads me through moonlight only to burn me with the sun. She's taken my heart and she doesn't know what she's done. I feel her breath in my face, her body close to me. Can't look in her eyes, she's out of my league. Just a fool to believe I have anything she needs. She's like the wind. I look in the mirror and all I see is a young old man with only a dream. Am I just fooling myself that she'll stop the pain and live without her? I'll go insane. I feel a breath in my face, a body close to me. Look in her eyes, she's out of my league. Just a fool to believe I have anything she needs. She's like the wind. I feel your breath in my face, your body close to me. Look in your eyes, you're out of my league. Just a fool to believe,
just a fool to believe
she is riding the wind.
Just a fool to
just
believe.
Somebody who's taught me about the kind of person I want to be, Miss Frances Housewood.
Now I've had the time of my life, though I never felt this way before. Yes, I swear it's a truth, and I owe it all to you.
Thank you.
Shall make merry.
Hooray, hooray, hooray,
hooray.
there.
Away! All of you! I shall be alone with my little desert flower. Send for a whiskey and soda, Corporal.
Yes, sir.
Now, back to the moon. Ah, yes. Have you missed me, my desert flower? Ah, that pretty voice. I adore you.
Sir!
Thank you. has finished and Ascot has run.
It's time for the country, it's time for the
soon be clever.
the tram. Or you may think I'm hanging round to steal a call. But no, I'm not a crook. And if you think that's what I look, I'll tell you why I'm here and what my motives are. I'm leaning on that post at the corner of the street in case a certain little lady comes by. Oh me, oh my, I hope the little lady comes by. I don't know if she'll get away, she doesn't always get away, but anyway I know that she's
the sound though. I can't find it.
Oh,
how dare you?
Oh, very daring. Hello, we're in a bit of bother here.
We are still single and all alone.
Thank you. our song was called At the End of the Day from Les Mis. I imagine a lot of you may well have seen it. And this is a very difficult slot to fill, Nate, because as soon as I walk on, we know about 3 minutes from now, it's not just at the end of the day, it's at the end, or 3 minutes from the end, of a 12-month stint. 12 months from planning through to rehearsing. I think this time last year I said crying, blood, sweat and tears. And the same again this year. But we've made it, and I think you've got to agree with me, really. I couldn't ask for any more of this lot. They've been terrific. The amount of hard work that's gone into this year's show, and just during this week, there's over 300 people running around backstage, on stage, in front of stage, front of house. So much hard work this year. And I've watched a few bits of the show tonight. I've seen an awful lot because this week has been extremely hard. We've had people dropping down like flies all over the place. People going sick. One girl went off in an ambulance last night. She's back here tonight, though. Some of them have been key players as well, and everybody else is fielding. We've had people learning dance steps in the wings just before they come on, and well, I don't think you'd have noticed, I certainly didn't, because I've done very well. And the audiences we've had this week, fantastic. It always lifts the cast, and on behalf of the cast, I would like to thank all of you and everybody else that's come this week, because you've all been tremendous. Just to finish off then, to make the picture complete, I think really we've got to bring just a few more people on the stage, just a couple of them, just to make our finale complete. So have a good, safe journey home, ladies and gentlemen, and perhaps we might see you next year.